First of all, we have a Skype call for 5 minutes with Porto, Santander, and Recife. The other cities participating in Hacker City, just to hear what they have done. They stop at the same moment. I will call Abigail to help me. She doesn't want to, but if everyone says in the audience, Abigail, come on, Abigail, come on, yeah. Because she organized it, so besides the applause, she deserves the applause because the last few weeks she did everything. So without her, it wouldn't have succeeded. So thank you very much up front. I don't know what's going to happen exactly.
Olha aqui, Claudio.
Hello, everybody. Okay. Can I have your points, please? In the back, come over to the front, please. It's much more cozy over here. And you can sit over here.
They're gone.
They are gone, so it was spectacular. Yeah. Are we waiting for one more try? Hello.
Hello, Abigail, are you there?
Yes, we are. Can you hear us?
Fala aí. Um minuto que configurar aqui, só um minuto.
I only understand a few minutes.
Okay.
We will proceed because we cannot wait. No. Druk maar weg.
Abigail, can you hear us?
Yeah,
we can. Yes, hello. So, can you guys start, Abigail?
Okay. Jij moet praten achter de computer. You have to speak, because otherwise they cannot hear you.
Abigail, Amersfoort, can you guys start?
Say something, Abigail. Oh, technology. I'm longing for the good old days when we had cassette players and and just pencils. It's quite interesting, but just we quit because this is not going to work, I think. So this was Porto, Santander, RAC. Yeah, hope you liked it. And we will excuse to them later on because it takes too much time to get a good connection. So first of all, welcome everybody, and I have to say thank you. And I think it's applause for yourself for all the hard work you did 24 hours. I see white faces and small eyes and things like that, so hope you're still awake. Abigail, do deze maar weg. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So thank you for all the hard work. What we are going to do now, and I think I heard for some of you it's quite new to have a pitch of 3 minutes, and 3 minutes is very short. And especially when you have a good idea, you want to talk a bit about it for much longer. But we have three remaining ideas. Sorry? Who is joining? Are you joining four? You're back? You're back or not? There was a misunderstanding, I think. Okay, but you're joining the others with three proposals or not? Okay, we'll just see what's happening. Okay, it's very okay. So what we are going to do is to see the proposals. We have a judge in front of us, three people. So if you present, focus on them and convince them of your idea, I will introduce them shortly. On the most, on the left for me, Martin Eikenboom, he's from Deloitte. He will look at your idea from the business perspective. Have you viable business plan? Have you thought about your price model? Things like that. How about scalability? In the middle, it's the alderman from the city of Utrecht, Victor Everhart. And he will look from Amersfoort and Utrecht if it helps the cities with your idea. And José Manuel Cantera, he's from the Fireware organization. He will look at technology, what you say about using Fireware. So business, city, and technology. So address your ideas to them. So they, what we do is you have 3 minutes for your presentation, and then they have 7 minutes to ask questions. And then we do the next one. Okay? And afterwards, the jury considers all the ideas. We take about 15 or 20 minutes, I think, to think about the ideas. Then we come back and we say, simple, who has won and who has number two, number three, and things like that. And we will explain that more later on. Okay, we didn't have who will start. Did you think about that, Abigail? Are you ready over here to start? No? No one is ready. The jury is fit for now, so if you start, you can impress them the most. You start, okay. Who wants the microphone? Yeah?
So is there a timer or anything? Okay.
Are you ready?
I am. We are on live and we are connecting you with life again. So we are in, our environment is getting smarter and smarter. We just finished connecting all the computers together and created an infinite amount of information on the internet. Now we start connecting things together. So what do we do with all that information? How are we gonna walk through that world? And that's the exact question we as a group asked. We thought, what about the people? How do they gonna navigate through this new world? So we started to think of this user walking through this new world where everything and everybody is a sensor or has a sensor. What does it need? What does the user need? We answered that question with a compass. We started with, well, it needs a compass, right? If you walk through this new world, you don't know how it works, you need a compass. So we started thinking of an app that works as a compass. So this compass that navigates on something, right? A compass navigates on something. So we thought, well, it should navigate on bubbles of relevance. These are our bubbles of relevance. So the first bubble of relevance is a social bubble. It's the bubble that's around you directly. It's that you can see the people, you can connect with people, you can share content directly. I can connect with you guys and share this presentation on your phone right now. The second bubble is the environmental bubble. It's the bubble where everything around this area, not only this campus party, but the other conferences going on, the shops on the station, all the other stuff you can connect with. The personal bubble, that's the most interesting bubble, I think. It's the highly personal, tailor-made advice bubble. You can get always traffic information, highly personalized, based on all the data that's available in this area, or shopping experience. Very highly recommendable. What? Okay, so here's the app, how it works. So we are at the campus party. We scan, we push the button, it scans, it gives us results. What is relevant for me? First of all, the speakers, because I'm here, I wanna see who is speaking. I can connect with the speakers, I can share the content with them, and I can share content with me. The second layer, the second bubble, is what's the greater area, what's going on there, what are the shops, what other events are going on. And here, apparently this user is having a highly personalized longing to know when he wants to go home, he pushes this button and he gets highly personalized advice. When he wants to shop, this button. When he wants to party in the Tivoli, this button. But this, the user can, it's like highly customizable. If this, then that from the Internet of Things, connecting all the data together. Yeah, we are on live, connecting you with life. Thank you very much. Oh yeah, we have a demo, but it's full of bugs. But if you're interested, you can come talk with us afterwards and we show the demo.
So you worked out a demo in 24 hours, then I respect for that. So I go to the jury if they have any questions to ask. Where shall I start with you, Jose?
So what five generic enablers are you using in your demo, and what functionality are they covering?
Okay, what are you doing with Fiverr?
Well, can you go one slide back, then I can. The third layer, that's the layer where the third bubble, we kind of connect all that data with each other that's available through the Fiverr network to the databases. I think my ICT people here, they can answer the question maybe a little bit more in detail on how they thought about it. But this layer is about the Internet of Things. This is based on all combined information that is available. Do you guys want to say something about it?
Yes. We thought the Fiverr would be useful to the third area on the screen by getting information about where it's busy, like if there is a lot of noise somewhere, you can use the platform to know if it's busy, so you can walk around it. Like if you are at a square with a lot of cafes, where it's busy, like the node in Utrecht, you get a notification when you're walking to it, and they think from, maybe it's better to walk around it because you are walking around there like a quarter to pass it.
Crowd control,
simply.
Okay, that's you use it for the third part with the Fiverr and the connected things and the personal information. Okay, shall I go? I take you as last, Victor. Okay, Martin, from the business perspective.
Yeah. Can you tell me something about the business case? Who are you making this for? Who is going to pay for it? What kind of budget do you need to make it? Something about that.
Okay, who's going to pay for this, and what's your business model?
Okay, well, in this case, we first need users. The app needs to be downloaded, and this social bubble where we talked about is gonna create the first batch of users. We imagine like if we could like have a pilot in Utrecht or in Amersfoort, we could say like, okay, so let's target students, make this useful for students in Utrecht, for example, and then start hooking up. If we have, let's say, 50,000 users in Utrecht, it starts getting interesting for the NS and the Arbers or all the shops, all the restaurants, all the clubs to start also, let's call it broadcasting on this app. We're going to enable them to create this unique experiences around their venues around their venues and make them available when these students are using this app when they in their daily lives. So the business model is we sell this to third parties, but we first have to create a lot of users. Does this answer your question a bit, or?
Not entirely,
okay, so.
But just wait, because we have only 7 minutes for all questions, so I have a question, and perhaps you can mix your answer in.
Okay.
About the city, you can keep it, I have two now.
Okay. Very good.
Okay, thank you. Interesting idea, and it's all about the user. And
yes.
Coming to Utrecht Central Station or Amersfoort Central Station, you have different types of users.
Yeah.
Which one you're aiming at first? And that's maybe also connected to the business plan, because we have people that come here and just pass on because it's the biggest railway station in the Netherlands. But there are also people living in Utrecht. How do they use this kind of interesting new idea? And there are people that are coming there for 1 day or 2 days. So more about that. I'm interested on that.
And the users, like what type of users?
Yeah.
Well, how I answered the question with the students, I think this was a great way to start with students, but it should be also very interesting for tourists to use this, because just keep on in mind that we thought of this as a compass, right? So it enables you to navigate better in the new world we're gonna be in. So tourists are very interesting, but also the people who live in Utrecht, not per se students, can use this to just explore their city in a whole new way, or to find out, because this third layer, they can create this personalized advice apps.
But perhaps you can make it a bit more concrete, but the question is, and the business model and the users, if you have 2 months from now,
yeah,
to deliver your app.
Yeah.
Who are you aiming at in these 2 months from now?
I would say students, for sure. I would say aim at students, and that we are in 2 months we could be up and running for students with this app, and yeah.
And in these 2 months, how are you connecting to third parties to pay for your content, or what's your idea about that?
Well, I would do simultaneously. I would target students and start marketing for them, but simultaneously go with the Arbor, for example, or the Tivoli, places where students are, places where students go, and start doing pilot cases with those, and start figuring out how the users are actually gonna enjoy this app.
Okay, time flies when you're having fun, so your 7 minutes are over.
Okay,
thank you very much for your explanation and your idea. Okay?
Yeah, thank you very much, guys. Good luck, everybody.
Hey, madam. Yeah, thank you. Okay, next one. Yeah? Okay.
Hi, I'm Irene. And I have already 2 years I'm evolving this idea. The idea solves the problem of where is my fiets? Because many people in Utrecht have stress about that, and sometimes they really lose it. They just even do not know anymore where your bike is, and then it's lost. Well, it's a good bike. And this problem grows with larger places to stall your bike. Oh, I would like to do it in Dutch, actually.
Je kan deze gebruiken als je dit
doet. Oh ja, dat is ook veel beter. 33.000 komen er. En dat betekent ook dat de gemeente steeds meer fietsen moet opruimen. Als mensen dit probleem hebben natuurlijk. En ondertussen wordt de capaciteit van de fietsenstalling gebruikt. En dat is zonde, want daar zou iemand anders al minimaal 30 dagen kunnen staan. Dus dat is het probleem wat ik graag wil oplossen. Met 16.000 fietsen per jaar verwijderen is de gemeente al 1 miljoen kwijt aan handhaving van dit probleem. Nou, nu los je natuurlijk ook later soms mensen bewust hun fiets achter. Maar in ieder geval, waarin het niet de bedoeling is, dat in ieder geval minder. Dat scheelt een hoop stress. En we hebben tegenwoordig allemaal technische mooie oplossingen met GPS, LoRa, Bluetooth, NFC, Fireware met sensors. Ik heb verschillende oplossingsrichtingen. En ik denk voor je MVP moet je het simpel houden. Misschien met een NFC-tag. Dat je in ieder geval weet in welk rek die staat van allemaal. Maar misschien wil je op termijn echt altijd weten waar echt je fiets staat. GPS is onvoldoende in grote stallingen, want het kan niet over de verdiepingen heen. En door al beton krijg je allemaal ruis op de lijn. Dus ik denk ook dat er aan de stalling zelf eventueel wat referentiepunten moeten komen om het secuur genoeg te maken. Hoe kan Fireware daarbij helpen? Mij is verteld dat ze goed zijn in visualisatie en GIS. En je plaatst eigenlijk een soort sensor in de fiets. En eventueel kun je ook extra sensoren in de fiets plaatsen die ook weer allerlei data geven over waar is het druk, wat is de temperatuur, waardoor we allemaal veel steeds beter weten wat er allemaal aan de hand is in de stad. En dat je ook veel meer leert over fietsen en stallen en fietsen.
One minute.
Oh, shit. Oh ja, nou, dit zijn de baten. Maar je kan ook vooral dat optimaliseren van die fietsenstalling. Waar is plek, waar is geen plek? Op een betere plek staan, omdat je anders altijd op dezelfde plek gaat staan, omdat je hem anders altijd vergeet waar die staat. En je weet ook waar fietsen dus te lang al staan. Als iedereen dat heeft, dan weet je waar ze te lang staan. Dan kan je ze misschien zelfs een waarschuwing geven. Van als je hem nou neemt nog een dag om hem weg te halen. Nou ja, Internet of Things, Smart Mobility, dit ben ik. Ik heb ook al eerder Lean Startup, ben ik ervaren in. Ik heb zelf een app gebouwd 2 jaar geleden, 2000 users in een jaar. Ik werk bij CAP, Chipolo geprobeerd. En ik heb hier op de campus allerlei interessante mensen gevonden die mee willen denken. De founder van de OV-fiets, electro-engineer van de Things Network, mensen van de provincie en de gemeente en natuurlijk mijn collega's van CAP en iemand die ook al een electrical lock heeft bedacht en gemaakt. Die liet hij hier zien. En dit zijn mijn bronnen en dit zijn de criteria. Dat was het.
Oké. Okay.
Just in time.
Just in time. Okay. So we switch to English because.
Yeah.
And I have to translate a little bit. Did you understand anything, José?
Well, 10% or something like that.
10%, okay. 10%. But in basic, it's track your bicycle using sensors. NFC at first, what she said, about information, where is your bicycle? Because a lot of bicycles get lost in the Netherlands. And she has ideas about making that more easy. Okay. So you see, a 3-minute pitch is also possible in 10 seconds.
Yeah.
Okay. But do you want to ask about the technology?
Yes. It's your you have an initial prototype of this application, and what data from the city of Utrecht and from Fireware are you planning to use, and what Fireware generic enablers you plan to use with this application?
Yeah. I had 5 minutes this afternoon to talk to your technical guys, so I do not really fully understand the potential of Fireware, but what I see as an opportunity that we can feed at least Fireware with more data about more places, and maybe we can do a partnership or something. But I do not really understand how Fireware can help me. But it was quite a smart guy, so I think. Some consulting.
Try a little bit better, because this is not going to help you.
No. But you also used the LoRa thing, and I think I will need for the scalable solution. I need LoRa.
And explain that, because you said you tried LoRa because indoors with GPS and things like that. So how do you want to use that?
Yeah, LoRa is a low battery solution. Because you have a beacon and on your bicycle, and LoRa can enhance that and localize it exactly. So probably Fireware can help with accessing the data on an appropriate API or something. Yeah.
Okay, we come back on technology perhaps later. But yeah. Martin,
business side. Well, first of all, I like the idea because there are many bikes in the Netherlands. But the success of your app. Well, depends on, let's say, the amount of bicycles that have this, well, sensor or whatever you want to call it. How are you going to make sure that everybody's going to use that sensor? What's in it for the user of the cyclist?
Yeah, you always are sure where your bike is. And for example, I always place my bike on the same spot because then I remember where it is. And also when I have to take the train at Spoor 19 And I have to walk a lot. It's more than 15 minutes sometimes when it's busy in the station. But when I park my bike on the other side, where there's also many, maybe more place, because I know, because of the smart information systems, then it takes less time for me.
So part of your solution is that you know where there are empty spots for your bicycle.
Yeah, and that I dare to use that because I remember where my bike is. I still have now the routine to place it always on the same spot because otherwise I think I will maybe lose it. Yeah. And beside a byproduct maybe is that you always know where your bike is, so when it's stolen you can get it back. And also maybe you dare to go with your electrical bike. Yeah.
Well, final question, isn't this a problem that which is specific for the Netherlands?
It's specific for places where there are many, many bikes. Yeah. So I think in the Netherlands we have many bikes, but in China they also seem to have many bikes. So maybe we can sell something to China instead of buying of them, announcing our balance.
Yeah, your idea is for the city of Utrecht and also for Amersfoort right in the middle, because we have a huge question about where do we put our bikes?
Yeah.
Can it be indoor and even outdoor? So yeah. That's one of my questions. You're talking about indoor, but also outdoor storage. Is it a real problem? So
yeah.
That's a first question.
Yeah, this is also outdoor possible. Okay. Yeah, that's no problem. Okay. Yeah.
And the second question I have is like, what can we do as a municipality, because you're saying we can attend people that they have still parked their bike there and they should remove it.
Mm-hmm.
Is there anything in between or possible that we can do that, or is the information just to the user itself? Can we break in this system that easy as a government, because it's your own property, and to take out a property from somebody else is quite complicated.
Yeah, I think now we have put it as a service that you can park your bike for free. So I think the user should cooperate with the municipality because they provide that free service. So maybe indeed when you're biking your park too long, then you get a warning of the municipality. Remove it earlier. And in a further state, that's more, but that you can maybe verhuur your fiets in the meantime. So then you can optimize the capacity of the stallingen also.
Can you say something about your business model? Because I heard nothing. Who's going to pay for this?
Yeah, I'm thinking of different things. Maybe an app where you can scan with NFC. That's a small, it's not also that expensive in hardware. But maybe also something with a really smart lock. Because then you cross-sell it with the lock, and then it's a good lock. And you know where your new bike maybe is stolen, at least for the short term. Maybe the thieves, they take your bike with the lock first, and then they remove the lock in their own working space. So when you're fast enough, then you can track it back. And also on the long term, you can when it's electrical lock, you can hire your bike.
So the user has to pay for it with their lock or something else?
Yeah,
and they have to pay for it.
Yeah,
and
the or maybe the privileged places in the when you use it, any privileged places, or also when you just use it as a channel, and then you do not have to really how is it called, the barcode scanner, but then when you just drive by, then it scans already.
One more question, because it's about who is going to pay.
Yeah.
But if you want to use it, and for example, we have 10,000 bicycles in Utrecht.
Mm-hmm.
What's your idea of getting 10,000 bicycles equipped with your sensor? What's your idea about creating scale?
I think that this problem really, when the Lean Startup says, when you ask people, do you recognize the problem? Yeah, I have a friend of mine, maybe she, but I asked a lot in the Utrecht session, and maybe many people say, I have that problem. So it's really a problem to solve. And the Cipolo, for example, 15 euros, and some people say also, I would like to buy that. So it's really a problem. But my 7 minutes are probably over.
I've finished, yeah.
But I have many ideas to solve. You do not have to be fixed on your solution yet.
And one important question.
Yeah.
Did you check out the competition? Because I'm sure that this is already a thing.
Yeah, there are many people inventing on this to track your things. But Bluetooth is, I tried Bluetooth solutions, but they're not good enough. GPS takes too much energy for this kind of things.
Okay, we can discuss this later because it's interesting.
New combinations.
And what we see,
needed.
City of Utrecht recognizes the problem. There are other competition perhaps, but it certainly is a problem that is recognized. So thank you very much.
Yeah, cool. Thank you for your attention.
Yeah, thank you. Doet hij het? Oh, that looks great. Urban something. Okay. Yeah? We are all waiting. No presentation mode?
That will be
all. Oh, that will be all. Okay. Okay, you don't need that. Okay.
Demo.
The third one. So, are you ready?
Yeah.
Almost. Yeah, just a second.
A little bit nervous.
Okay. We won't eat you.
I might eat myself, sir.
Okay. If you're ready, you can start.
Whew. That will be nice. Hi.
Take your time. No one is doing it. It's fine. Everyone here deserves our respect, so that's great.
This is the first time I'm using a microphone and standing on the stage, so it's pretty hard for me. So sorry. Yeah. So when I look around, I see a lot of technology, and I even hear about new inventions that will happen in near future, and that is amazing. I'm really looking forward to that things. However, everything has bad sides for inventions and stuff like that. And I don't like it. One thing about new things, that it will have an impact on our social life. And it will suffer. That's why we want to make people go out more instead of staying at home. And that is our problem. That people's social life is suffering. And we want everyone to be more social. Because of technology, people are more tend to use their phones and sit and do nothing. Just look at their screens. And to solve this problem, we have created a platform that will find the spots in the cities where people are gathering. And in this way, you will know where the action is happening. That is pretty cool. And the user gets feedback in the map, like a heat map or something like that, where it will show the big crowds that are gathering, and or the small ones, it doesn't matter, big ones, small ones. And this way, you can engage with your local community and join the social activities. To find these events, we are monitoring big amount of people by using IoT sensors like temperature, noise, and frequency. We parse this data to LoRa network and show the users the map where events are happening. And I will show you the heat map that I created. Wait. We created. Yeah, but it yet. Yeah. This is the map, as you can see. And this is like a feedback. If you press this button, for example, press it. You will see that these are the high activities, like where the big crowds are gathering. For example, if you press middle button, press it. Yeah, you will see that the less people are gathering here. For example, if you're the person that doesn't like crowds, and you're like, yeah, I would like to be with my friends or something like that, I would socialize like that. I will have a house party that has like 50 people. And we would use sensors like noise and would show it that, yeah, there is a party. Maybe I can crash it or something like that. And if you would press the less activities, you'll see that more stuff is happening. For example, the boat party also like has 10 people or something like that. And they're like just having fun. Yeah, this is the prototype that we are having. And
your time is up?
Yeah, I know. Yeah, yeah.
If your final word or?
My final word that, what it would be?
Otherwise think about social, it, yeah. There will be questions, so yeah, you can think about it. So I see this, it looks like a party already on the map.
Yeah, with the Christmas.
Yeah, it's like, yeah. Okay, yeah. Thank you very much for your presentation. And for your first time on stage with a microphone, you did great. Yeah. Jose.
Yeah, a couple of questions. One is, how do you plan to address privacy? Because it seems you can detect in certain areas is if there is more activity. So that's one question. And the second is how do you plan to monitor activity inside and because inside of the houses or whatever? And what alternatives? Because I suspect that you plan to use LoRa network connected to fiber, in which you can detect sound or all the ambient conditions in the street. But inside the houses, how do you deal with that?
And sometimes those are private sounds in house you don't want to use outside, even if it's a party. So how you deal with privacy issues and how you deal with inside sounds and things like that.
Okay, so the idea was that we have these modules that will have the LoRa chip connected to fireware, as you said, that will detect sound, heat, and other things that we can use to recognize a crowd of people. So this is especially interesting for clubs or we thought of the piano inside the central station to that's a good example indeed because we can place one of those sensors in there, and you know, mostly there's no one playing, but if there's someone playing that's really good, people will gather around, it will make noise, it will produce heat, and that is and that way we can detect it. People walking around the station, having our app or our application, can see, hey, there's someone really good playing the piano, and I have nothing to do right now. Instead of just sitting around being bored, you can go to the piano, enjoy listening to some music in the night.
What Jose said, okay, the piano is one example, so yes. It's public space, but you have sensors outside measuring noise as well, so that can be very private sometimes.
Yes, so the idea was not to just randomly place sensors everywhere. We only place sensors where it's where it makes sense. So under a piano, inside a club, inside public places where you come for activities. So it wouldn't make sense to place it in someone's house, because you know it's not a place where you should usually go for an activity. You just go to a club, the piano. You know, you name it.
Okay. Martin?
Well, I'm not sure if I understand the idea correctly. First of all, the plan that you have is trying to attract people to places which are already crowded, or something like that.
Yeah, what we do is we track large amounts of people, a congregation of people.
But doesn't it work the other way around, that if you are attracting a lot of people to a place, that you will get a real crowd and it will cause all kinds of problems? That's my first question. And the second question that I have is, who is going to pay for this solution? And because you need a lot of sensors and you need a lot of users, I'm not sure about that.
Okay, I'm not sure about, I didn't understand your first question, so I'm going to answer first the second. What we need is just the sensors that will be placed in public spaces, and that's all the infrastructure we actually need, because we will be using the Fiverr LoRa network. Who is going to pay for this? One business model that we proposed is the government or the local community wants to promote an event, so they are interested that a lot of people go there. So using our sensors and people that are using our application would say, okay, there is a big amount of people there, something is going on, let's check it out. Okay, that would be one option. And something else is on more private scale, a shopping mall would be really interested on seeing how large amounts of people are moving around, to what shops are they going, where are they staying more. And basically, we are tracking how people are moving around in big amounts over time.
More events in Utrecht, more crowded events.
I really liked the introduction of the idea that people should go out, meet each other, and build a society together. And I think that's very vital for any city, so also for Amersfoort and also for Utrecht. So that's the idea, the basic idea I really enjoy. The thing is that what kind of social event would I encounter when I see all those different colors popping up? To make a good decision, if I would go to a crowded gathering, or a middle crowded gathering, or even a quiet party, because my mood is like that. How do I know what's really going on there, and what should be the trigger then? More information, I think, you should add.
Yeah, exactly. On each of the points in the map, we would be missing a marker with what's going on there. And that's also related to the privacy issue. We would need a permission to apply all those sensors. So that means that we are putting them there for a reason. So we would label all those sensors saying, okay, the sensors that are in the area are tracking this specific event. So when this event gets enough people, it would be displayed in our map with the label about the sensors that are there for that reason.
And is in your model also a possibility that you could attract other friends of you to go to the same gathering? So it's also, yeah, the social event that you attract other people that you would like to meet there could go there also. Is that also into the system?
I didn't really understand your question.
I want to go to a social event, and I would like that three or four friends of mine would also go there.
Yeah.
Could you put that also on the screen? Or
definitely, the options are limitless. We also made a small demo of an application that when there is a new zone that pops up as a red alert, let's say, you get a notification on your phone, and it says, hey, that's this thing going on. And we could also implement social features like, oh, I'm there, I want to invite my friends. Hey, check this place out. It's really cool. Definitely.
Okay. Time's up. Thank you very much for your presentation.
Thank
and
you.
Your heat map. And it's very impressive in 24 hours to make something working. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, one more. You need your own laptop or?
My own laptop.
Moet je me nog even helpen of niet? Oh, dat doet hij. Hè? ready? Starting. Yeah. When I'm grown up, I want one like this as well. This is your car? This is your computer, okay. Not your car?
Not yet.
There's another mic if you need it. Just a question to the audience. Who is going to an event when he's invited to a crowded event with his friends? Are you going? Yes? If he invites someone, invites you and say, I know a nice event. Yeah? Puya ook, so you can go together. Puya's going as well, so. You're ready? There's another microphone you can use.
Hello and good afternoon to everyone. My name is Salvador Palomo. I came from Spain, and like you know, I love Tesla. Nikola Tesla first, and Tesla models and all that Elon Musk does. So this is an inspiration for my work. I'm an architect and an electrical engineer, and now I have my own company from 2 months ago. So, we could work about the station of Utrecht and another one I can't remember exactly now. But this is a very difficult name. So, I want to work about the station in Malaga. In Malaga, we have more than 300 days of sun per year. So, my presentation, once you have seen the ubication, I'm going to show you another. I can't find where is the mouse. Sorry. What is this?
It was on the map.
It was also on the map already.
It's at the bottom. Yeah, okay.
Yeah. This is the web of my enterprise. I have done on my own because the start is very soon. This is in Spanish, but in the next times it's gonna be in English. So, what is the project? The project is to improve the efficiency saving and efficiently energy in a station. So, how can we do that? With the sensors of the company is helping us to do this presentation. And we like to put garden roofs in our stations. These garden roofs are gonna improve the fresh air inside them. And we like to put solar panels, two types of solar panels in our buildings. Solar panels for electricity, because when electricity is more demanded in Spain, and is when the sun is shining a lot. So for the cool air, electricity can help us. And in the other hand, we can use solar panels, not for electricity, so it's for warm water, and some kind of warm walls, warm grounds, and whatever.
You only have 1 minute.
So, I don't need 1 minute. Okay. It's okay. Can Oscar, this is my friend from Belgium, come here? So he could help me for my English. Sorry, my English is not very well. In Spain, almost anyone speak English like.
But just one question before we go to the judge. What are you asking from them? What is your question to the judges?
I need him to translate the questions of.
Okay, but before he needs to translate, you have an idea. And they are asking questions. What is your idea and what do you want from the jury?
What is my idea?
Yeah.
My idea, I have selected that. My idea is putting grounds, green grounds, green...
Ground with solar panels.
Solar panels and green roofs.
And green roofs for electricity.
For electricity and for warm water.
And for
warm air, too.
And for
with fine coils. How can I finance that? For example, for a leasing.
Let me just wait. We ask them the questions first. Otherwise, you're going to repeat. But we start here first. Jose, you had a disadvantage that someone talks Dutch. Now you have an advantage that it's in Spanish.
In
so
Spanish?
you can read what's over there.
Sorry for being, but the thing is that I'm not seeing here any idea for the contest of the hackathon. So, I mean,
no idea.
Do you think I have no idea? Do you really think I have no idea?
No, I'm not saying that. I'm saying that here you have not presented any idea related to the hackathon we are organizing. Yes, this is my my point.
It's your opinion. Okay,
yeah,
I have to respect.
But you have to respect. But we asked for solutions for the station area of Utrecht Amersfoort, and electricity and solar energy is great idea. But it would be better if you had said something about the problems in these station areas.
I think this solution could be great too for Utrecht.
Yeah.
Maybe more than electricity panels. It will be more necessary, water panels, but you can translate the idea perfectly to Utrecht, I think.
Martin, you want to say something?
Okay.
Well, I have the same feeling as my companion juror. I'm sorry, but I don't get the idea. I understand what you're saying about the solar panels and stuff, but I miss something about data. Using sensors to improve, let's say,
I need sensors. I need sensors, and I tell you. Okay.
Dat snap ik ook wel, maar laten we even vriendelijk blijven.
For temperature.
Wil jij iets vragen?
For. And I have, what is the climate? And really, I need the sensors, of course. When the hot water is needed, when the solar panels have to work, when the system has to work. But
okay.
You think it's no idea? I'm gonna.
We don't respect him
again. Now there are three jurors, so.
No one is saying that it's not a great idea because everyone wants sustainable energy and solar panels and things like that. So a lot is happening in the Netherlands as well with solar panels for electricity and things like that.
Know.
So when you started with Tesla, everyone was interested because batteries in Tesla and solar energy.
No,
yeah.
The Tesla car was the back of my computer only. And
Tesla.
And this idea more than Tesla Motors. That is one of the companies of Elon Musk, is more similar to Solar City.
Yeah. Would we agree? Victor, you want to ask something?
Yeah, I have a question. You also referring to Malaga, that you already have installed there already those solar panels. And I would like to ask you, going to the Netherlands, is it the same energy you can put up to, if you look in our weather conditions in the Netherlands, like to Malaga, or do you see differences between that?
Yeah. Perdona. Oscar? No. That's not the question. That's not the point. So we need your sensors. I need your sensors because we have to study what that station needs and what another station needs of electrical solar panels for cool air and electrical solar panels for hot water and fan coils.
Okay. We have had our questions. We have our four presentations. So thank you very much for your idea. And every idea is good, so with all the respect, so thank you very much. Okay.
My name is Salvador Palomo, and Electrotest and Novatec is my company from Malaga. Thank you very much.
Everyone knows you now. Yeah. Okay. We have had four presentations. What we are going to do now is discuss with the judges for a quarter. So it's 8 o'clock now, 8:15. We come back together here, everyone, to announce the winners of this contest. So we'll hope to see you back within 15 minutes, okay?
Weet je dat jullie officieel nu weg hadden gemoeten?
Om 8 uur, nee, om 8:30 volgens mij.
Op het schema staat 8 uur de volgende, die stond al klaar, maar maakt het dan maar niet uit.
Staat er al een andere klaar?
Oké,
maar is er nog een volgende hierna dan?
Ja.
Okay.
Maar het wordt overlegd nu met
Oké. Zullen we even daar gaan zitten?
attention for a second? Netherlands of Engels.
We have built an app and we are searching for beta users. So you can give your email address and send the link of the beta to you. And maybe you will win a trip. Please give your email address.
And what's your app about?
The app is a digital democracy tool. We let people vote on a specific topic that is on the news. It's crowdsourced also the question. And then you get to see how all the rest of the world voted. For that, we need a lot of better users. Yeah. And we're willing to lotterize one ticket, one vacation for all the people that are going to be.
What's the trip called? Maybe Bahamas, maybe Finance, maybe.
Maybe
Amersfoort.
Maybe the Utrecht Burst, the campus party. No, we want to give somebody a vacation that he wants. We have a certain budget for it, and if it will be within the budget, and we cannot afford a trip to Mars. You know?
Yeah,
the
business card.
But if it will be something. Like, then I'm out.
Yeah, see somebody with a business card. Because all I want is a business card.
Would you like to participate as well? We just sent you a link to our app, to your email, and you can win a vacation. You also don't have to use the link if you don't want to. Would you like to participate?
The concept?
Okay, I think we have a verdict. Hi, Jill. Okay, we're waiting for the chairman of the What can I say? I have a business card. Do you want one? What for? Two? Home? Home.
we are searching for better users for our app. We'll send you a link of our app.
Okay, but I will give it later to you because I have to present now. So if you wait 15 minutes, yeah? Wil je meteen beginnen, Victor? Ja, dan laat ik jou het woord geven. Dus zeg je ook even dat ze dan een maand hebben om inderdaad...
Ja. Oké, thanks. Thanks for the excellent presentations. We really love that as a jury that we have four different ideas putting on stage and that you put so much effort into this, at least last 24 hours, to think about the problems we have in our two cities, Utrecht and Amersfoort, in the railway station. We had a hard discussion in this 15 minutes who would be having the challenge to go on and have this special prize. And we thought about it that we would like to give three ideas the 1 month ahead, that after 1 month we will decide as a city that we could improve that idea to a next stage. And that is that special prize we don't want to offer at this moment, but we really would like to have these three ideas challenging again in 1 month's time to see where you bring it to what kind of stage that we could improve it more. The idea of the last that was presented, I don't know if you're still here, the man from Malaga. It was hard for us to grasp the real in-depth idea you put on stage, but the whole idea of solar energy and having data to track down where this could be put into in our cities, it's a lovely idea. But it was hard for us to understand what could be the benefit out of it right now or the coming months. But thank you for your presentation. So you're on the fourth place. Then we have our third place winner. I don't know where the... we have the screen here. It is the idea that is really a big issue in our cities. It's about the bike. So where is my fiets is on third place. Thank you. We would like to challenge you to have this next month getting more in-depth where the solutions could be found, where you find your bike back. Because we really like the idea. It's right on the spot of the issues in our towns. But what could we benefit from a municipality if you put your bike outside with no indoor facilities? Where can you track it really on spot? Can you really pinpoint out where it's standing? And how do we have this data combined together so we can do something with it? And what is the motive of the user itself to install it in his bike? So that's the challenge we would like to offer you on this issue. Yes? Okay. Then the first and the second winner. The second place is the lovely idea to have people coming out and join together and to make the city more alive. So the winner is, that's the automatic thing we have, is the user app itself. So all the congratulations to you. But also, the runner-ups, we would like to challenge you the coming months to see if you could have more background information installed in this idea of getting people coming to festivals, coming to smaller festivals, and think about more about this privacy issue. We thought about it from the municipality. It's very interesting for crowd control, so you could see where people are moving around in your city, but your basic idea is about people meeting each other. So if you could improve that, we'll see where we'll be in 1 month's time. And you have the second place. We have also this for you. Okay, thank you. And then the first, the winner, please come on stage. We really like your idea. We think it's very important that if people are coming to Amersfoort or Utrecht, how should they go on in our city? It's also beneficiary to our cities that people will stay in our city, will find interesting places, will talk about it. And if you could improve this app, not only to the students itself, but also to people coming to our towns, and maybe that's the challenge we would like to put on to you the coming month. If you need students first to work it out, of course, but we are thinking that it could be more improved if you could it also install it more directly for those people who are coming to our cities and want to stay and want to enjoy our city. So that is the idea we want to give to you. But thank you for your presentation and all the luck for your first prize winner. Thank you. Okay. Yeah, you can.
Just the second prize winners, we actually, when you were having a meeting, gathering, we were talking already, and we actually thought a good plug-in kind of way in our We envisioned a platform, and they created this really cool plugin for our platform. So this is cool that we can maybe we can find combine a way it. To combine it, yeah, make it even better.
Okay, thank you. That's a good.
And that's also for the bikes, by the way, because I see there. I mean, users want to know all the time where are their bikes. If they can just push the button, where's my bike? It can be in our platform.
Okay, I think we have a combination here. Thank you very much.
Okay, can I say a few more things? Okay, is your mic working? A few more things. What Victor already said is what we want you to do in the next months, because you won your prizes, but you only had 24 hours to work out your first idea. To work out your idea a little bit more in the next month, Abigail will have has all your details, so she will contact you about that. So if you have a more detailed plan and idea in the next month, then we introduce you to the business support, the technical support, and the marketing support. And after 1 month, and Victor said it in its introduction, we decide, and it can be all three of you, with the cities together, which idea has been worked out the best, because the cities see the potential of your ideas, but they need a little bit more improvement to decide if the additional prize we had to implement your idea in Utrecht or Amersfoort is feasible based on your 1 month work you have. So if you do your best the next month, work out your idea, you have the opportunity to win another 25,000 euros to implement it in Utrecht or Amersfoort. And I think for a startup, the best way to get your idea implemented is to be introduced in the network of a city and have the business, technical, and marketing support. So go to sleep for a night, then Monday go back to work for a month, and hopefully we see you next month, and we will be organizing something within the next month to invite you all to present it. So we come back to that. So thank you very much for this 24 hours, and hope to see you soon.